please. You're not even listening to me. No. No, that's not true. You spoke to Joan. You know what she's like.
Well, at least we've still got each other.
But they're my parents.
And you're their daughter. And you both think you're right. But it's not possible.
Some areas, very few areas, I'm sure, they went in Melbourne where neighbours do this. It works rather successfully.
Well, Patterson, you're shot, is it? May I?
In proximity to the
Let's try it off the cushion.
And if your house is unoccupied by day, give yourself another 8 points on your channel. Well,
that was real good.
Oh, a bit out of practice, I'm afraid. Well, carry on. And keep the noise down a bit, will you, ladies? Thank you.
What the hell's got into her?
She's gone soft.
Now she's on with Malone.
Bloody hell, the freak's gone gaga.
Well, I'm Malone's case. She certainly worked a miracle.
Nice you to keep our appointment, Miss Ferguson.
What do you want, Kelly? I have done all the deals I'm going to do with scum like you.
You wait till I tell
you. You tell her and see how far it gets you.
You can't watch Malone every hour of the day.
Touch her, Kelly, and you are dead. Now get out of here!
Hi, I thought I heard the door. I hope you're hungry because dinner's going to be a knockout.
Terri, will you leave dinner for a minute?
I can't just yet. You pour us a drink and I'll be in a minute.
Terri, please.
Like them?
Yeah, they're lovely and expensive.
Oh, I couldn't resist them. I thought they'd cheer the place up a bit. You look tired. Sit down, I'll get the drink. Didn't you have a good day?
No, I haven't had a good day.
What's the matter?
Terri, you and I have got some big decisions to make. It's about time we talked about them. So, if the women didn't know before, Kelly and Patterson would have told them by now.
I don't care. Really, I don't care.
Oh, Terri, will you stop and think for a minute?
Well, all right, it might make life a bit difficult for
a bit difficult? I'll bet they've already thought of 100 ways to blackmail us.
Oh, Joan, now you're not thinking. We simply lay our cards on the table to Anne Reynolds. If we tell her everything...
Oh, I can't do that. Besides, I don't want anyone to know.
Why not? Are you ashamed of me?
Oh, Terri.
I've always admired you for your honesty.
What's the point in being honest if nobody bothers to understand? So just deny everything.
Everything all right in here, lady?
Hello.
Better do a quick tidy up in here. Bloody dyke! Come on, let's give us a hand. Oh, screw the bad enough, but when they're dykes, it's even worse. My mum couldn't handle them either. This Malone's all right. Oh, she'll end up as ugly as a freak. Give me the creep. Gee, she must be desperate to have it on with Burgess. They're the ones that should be put away. I'm not sure you've got the right to say how people should live. You on the turn or what?
No, I just think you're talking about things you don't know anything about.
Oh, I know about the freak, Mrs. Dunwoody.
Terri! Oh, thank God, I didn't know if you'd be here. You've resigned, haven't you?
What?
Terri, what's happening?
It's my mother. She's in the hospital.
Hospital?
I had a call at work. She's taken a massive overdose of pills. She hates me and nothing's going to change that.
Won't be long now. We're still doing practice runs.
That's not it.
It's rubbish. First try, that's all.
Oh, no, it's not the right one.
Oh, come on, come on. I'm sure it's terrific.
What on earth?
Yes, well, she would have phoned you herself, Dr. Malone, but I'm afraid she's very distressed. So I thought I ought to be for both of us. And you won't reconsider? Yes, Well, I must say, I think it's very poor that her own parents can't...
Well, what did he say?
Well, she's coming along nicely, but not quite up to having visitors just yet.
He doesn't want to know about me, does he?
Terry, I'm sure he didn't mean that. I mean, given time... Oh, come on, Terry, you're just going to have to snap out of this. And maybe it was an accident after all. Perhaps she didn't really mean to harm herself.
It was no accident. They just can't accept.
Oh, Mrs. Morris.
Joan, something's come up. May I come in?
Yes. We've just heard that Terry's mother is seriously ill.
I am sorry. I didn't mean to intrude, but I thought you should see this.
What is it?
Most of the women have seen it already, I'm afraid. I thought you should know before you go to work tomorrow.
Why do they have to be so cruel?
Typical. I warned the governor they'd take advantage of that printing press. Mrs. Morris, would you mind?
Yes, of course. I'll see myself out.
Thank you.
Here are these papers I was telling you about, at least all the copies I could find so far. I mean, they've been circulated right throughout the prison.
I'm not surprised. Have them burnt immediately, will you?
Yes, I've already got it. I took a copy over to Joan and Terri last night. I thought they should know.
Not as though they'd been all that discreet. Even I overheard them talking, as I was saying to you, Meg. You seem to be the only one in the dark around here.
Tell Joan and Terri to report to my office as soon as they come in.
Yes,
you?
Of course.
Oh, hello, you two. Not interrupting anything, am I?
No.
Well... How's everything going?
You mean, how did we get on with the governor? Hmm? You just can't wait to find out, can you?
Oh, come on, that's not fair. I know what you're going through. Mervyn and I had to come under the same scrutiny when we decided to be together.
Hardly the same sort of scrutiny, is it?
I'm resigning as from today. Mrs. Reynolds has agreed to let me finish up tonight rather than work through my note.
Oh, you had to resign?
I didn't exactly have to. I thought it best, that's all. All I was doing was giving the girls a bit of a laugh. You'd reckon I'd kill someone. What side are you on, anyway? You sounded more like a screw than a screw. Speak of the devil. Here you made the front page, Miss Malone.
Lexie.
You've got what you wanted. I've resigned from Wentworth.
Are you leaving because of that article in the paper? That's right.
I reckon we got a right to know if we've been guarded by a pack of weirdos.
Do you mind repeating that, Patterson?
Oh, just joking, Miss Ferguson. You know me, always in for a laugh. Didn't mean nothing by it.
I'm sure you didn't. I'll take over now, Miss Malone. Well, we've had a real cosy truce lately, haven't we? Good chums. Very matey. Doing the right thing by one another. And then I see this. And so... back to square one, ladies.